Hello everyone, it's this time of the year again and Adobe has released a huge update for Lightroom and Lightroom Classic. And by huge, I actually mean game changing, since there is one big change which is going to be really helpful for us as landscape photographers. So besides a bunch of new presets and a few different crop settings, there are now a new set of selective adjustments. Let me show what they can do with this image. On the right side, you can see the menu up here has changed a little bit. We now have four icons: the crop, the spot healing brush, the red eye correction, and then there's the masking icon. Under the masking menu, there are the usual suspects like brush, linear gradient, and radial gradient, which I used all the time in previous videos. But now Adobe has added a few more things. For example, we now have a select subject and select sky mask. And down there you can also see the color, luminance and depth range masks, which in earlier versions were part of the radial and linear gradient tools. So let's go through those tools real quick. Although the brush, the linear gradient and the radial gradient have stayed the same, how you use them changed a little bit. So first, let me create a linear gradient for the foreground. I'm clicking this icon right here and you can see right next to the right hand side menu there is now a new masks menu. Here we have the new mask, which I'm going to drag up for the foreground, just like I did in the earlier versions. By the way, you can also see the gradient tool itself looks a little bit different, and you can also see the overlay is enabled right away. So let's just turn it off for now. And let's darken this real quick, just like that. Maybe add a bit of clarity in there. All right. Now this whole mask operation right here is in some way like layers in Lightroom. I can even rename them. So let's say gradient foreground. And thus I can just be a little more organized when doing the editing here. And with this new mask menu, I can continue adding different masks. So next up, let's add a radial gradient. You can see a new layer has appeared above the gradient foreground. So let's drag up this radial filter here. Add a little bit of sunlight on the left, just like that. I want to turn off the overlay. I don't need it in this case. And then let's push the blacks, decrease the dehaze maybe. Just adding some lovely light here. Turn up the warmth. In the menu on the right side, you can still see there is the feather slider. So we want to bring that up to make it soft, just like that. Here you have also the option to invert it, of course. Again, let's rename this radial gradient. Let's say sunlight left side. Perfect. Now that's pretty basic stuff, which most of you probably know already. But now let's take a closer look at the new additions. Again, I'm going to create a new mask, and this time let's just go with select sky. Here Adobe has included some kind of AI algorithm, which will just, as you can guess, select the sky. And with the overlay active, you can see it's doing a pretty good job at selecting the sky. Now, of course, there's a chance your subject or your foreground will be affected by the select sky mask. But don't worry, if you're clicking on the sky selection mask right here, you can add or subtract from the mask. Clicking on those buttons will give you a menu with all those known tools. For the purpose of removing or adding things, I would suggest to use the brush tool. And then I'm just brushing over the tree, since that's not part of the sky, and thus I'm removing part of the sky selection if needed. So the sky selection is looking pretty solid. Let's see. I do want to change the exposure, maybe make it a little darker and give it some more saturation here. Add a little bit of temperature, I guess. All right, that works really, really nicely. Maybe the effect isn't that visible, so let me turn down the exposure quite dramatically here. And you can see the mask is doing a really, really good job. Just up there above the grass, of course, it's a little tricky to mask out this area. But otherwise, it's working good. All right, then let's try the select subject mask. Again, Adobe's AI algorithm will select the subject pretty nicely, as you can see. It just got the tree as I wanted without the foreground here. However, we can see the mask right here isn't that precise, so we do need to subtract again using the brush tool with the auto mask setting right here, and I'm just brushing over this place. All right, up there, there's also a part of the sky included, which I don't want, of course. So I'm just removing it using the brush again. Okay, then let's see, what can we do with the subject? We could make it a little brighter maybe, but I do want to add a bit of texture, just like that. Then there are three more masks. In one of my most popular videos, I talked about rage masks. In that video, I basically used a linear gradient outside of the image so I can cover the whole photo. With this new update, this is not needed anymore. I can simply click on the new mask button, and now I'm just selecting color range. And with the color range mask active, you can see the mouse cursor now has changed to the eyedropper icon, and I can simply select the colors I want to change. So let's say the blue part of the sky right here. And by holding down the shift key, I can add multiple points which I want to change. So just like that, for example. So with this color range selected, let's deactivate the overlay. I guess I want to turn down the exposure in this part some more. Maybe give it a more bluer tone. Just like that. Perfect. And of course, this also works the same way with the luminance range. In this case, we do have settings in the right menu, which we know from previous versions. So right here we have the black point, and up there we have the point for the highlights. Let's say I do want to target the brighter parts of the image. It means I'm filtering out the darks by dragging this point to the right, and you can see how the overlay will change here. And what's really cool here is you can adjust the softness a little more precise than previously, since you have basically one extra point you can drag around with the slider right there. So this looks like a pretty good selection. Let's turn off the overlay. Now let's boost the whites in here. And also I want the highlights to be warmer, so I'm increasing the temperature. All in all, you can see that's a very, very huge update, which will change the raw editing process quite a bit, as it makes things a lot easier. And for certain things, I'm sure I won't even need Photoshop anymore. So that was the main feature I wanted to talk about in this video. If you have found anything more interesting about recent Adobe Lightroom Classic update, please let me know in the comments, since I just got the news and I'm trying this new version for the first time right now. So thank you for watching this video, and see you guys next time.